Okay, in this video now we are going to discuss about our next terms like power and energy. Okay, so in the earlier video we discussed about what work was, and now we discuss what power is. Okay, so the definition goes: power is the rate of doing work. The rate of doing work is said to be power. Okay, now the rate of anything means that particular thing by time. Okay, so here we have rate of doing work, so we can say power, from the definition goes, work done, we can say it as W, by time taken to do that work. Okay, time taken to do that work. So from here we can say that power depends directly on W, work done, okay, and inversely proportional or inversely on time. What do you mean by inversely on time? Directly depends directly on work means more the work, more will be the power. Inversely on time means more the time taken, less will be the power. Less the time taken, more will be the power. Okay, now there is another formula for power. If a constant force F is acting on a body, okay, there is a constant force F acting on a body, and the body displaces S in the same direction. Okay, the direction is same. That means cos 0 is 1. Okay, same direction. Then in such case, work will be force into displacement. Okay. And you know, power is actually work done by time, so you can say instead of work we can write F into S by time. And if you see S by time, displacement by time is actually V, velocity, so we can say power equal to F into V. Okay, this is the formula, this is another formula. So power is force into velocity. Now in if we write it in vector form, remember force is a vector and velocity is a vector, but power is not. So we'll write power, no vector sign over here because power is not a vector quantity, it is a scalar quantity, and force dot V. Remember, two vectors multiplying and giving us a scalar will always be a dot product, okay, dot product, not a cross product. So this is the vector form. Okay, now let us see this thing. Like if you have a coolie, suppose there is a coolie who does W amount of work, or you can say 200 joule of work. Coolie one, work done is 200 joule. Time taken. Suppose 100 seconds, okay, and you have coolie two. Work he has done is same, 200 joule. Time taken, suppose 75 seconds. Okay, now if we find power for both the cases, power you know is work done by time taken, so it will be 200 by 100, so it will be 2 watt. Okay, so we'll come to this unit of power, but then remember, in this case if we find power, so power over here will be 200 by 75, and that will come out to be 2.67 watt. Okay, you can do the calculation and see. So what we see over here is they have both done same amount of work, but the time taken by the first coolie was more and by the second coolie is less. So more the time taken, less is the power, you can see. And less is the time taken, more is the power. That is what we mean by power is inversely proportional to time. Okay, so remember this point. Now come to what units of powers are, units of power. So from the definition you can say power is actually work done by time. Work done, the unit is joule, and the unit for time is second. So we can say joule per second is the unit. Now this has been named as watt, okay, with a small w, and the short form is writing capital W. Okay, so the unit for power is watt. And how do we define this? Okay, how do we define this? We can say P equal to 1 watt when W equal to 1 joule and T equal to 1 second. Okay, so we can say if 1 joule of work is done in 1 second, then the power spent is said to be 1 watt. Okay, now there are a few multiples of this unit watt. Like if you are given megawatt or kilowatt, suppose you know 1 kilowatt, you studied this in class 9, the prefixes kilowatt is 10 to the power 3 watt. And similarly, 1 megawatt is 10 to the power 6 watt, and 1 gigawatt is 10 to the power 9 watt. Okay, and similarly, you have the subunits also. The subunits are like 1 milliwatt. Milliwatt is 10 to the power minus 3 watt, and 1 microwatt is 10 to the power minus 6 watt. Okay, now coming to the CGS unit, these were SI units. What is the SI unit? So the CGS unit of work, okay, so CGS unit is erg per second. Erg per second. Okay, why? Because you know the SI unit was joule per second, and you know joule, the CGS unit is erg. So erg per second. So you what is the relation between joule per second and erg per second? So remember, 1 watt, or we can say 1 joule per second, is equal to how much is 1 joule in terms of erg. So we have seen it is 10 to the power 7 erg into second. Second remains same over here. So we can say 1 watt is 10 to the power 7 erg per second. Okay. Now there is another unit of power. Okay, especially in terms of mechanical engineering, we refer to power with this particular unit, and that is called horsepower. Okay, horsepower. And now we denote it by HP. Okay, so what is the relation? 1 horsepower is actually, to be precise, it is 745.67 something watt. Okay, and we round it off to 746 watt. So if the question comes, what is 1 HP, like how much is 1 HP, so you will just write 1 HP is 746 watt. Okay. Coming to the difference between work and power, okay, I'm just dictating the difference. Work and power, you have understood both the terms. We have discussed work in the earlier video, so you can understand what the difference is. You know, the first is actually the definition. So work done is equal to product of force into displacement in the same direction. Okay, and over here you have the difference as power is actually the rate of doing work, that is work done by time. Also, now the second point, you can say work does not depend on T. That means it does not depend on time taken. Okay, but you can say power depends on time taken. P depends on time taken. We have seen that it is inversely proportional. Also, third point you can go about is with units. Unit is joule, capital J, and over here you can say unit is watt, capital W. Okay, so this is difference between work and power. Okay, our next topic of discussion is energy. Okay, so we have discussed what work was in the earlier video. We discussed what power is in this particular video earlier, and now we discuss what energy is. Okay, so now energy, according to the definition, if we see, the energy of a body is the capacity to do work. Okay, capacity to do work. This is the definition. Okay, so actually these work and energy are interrelated. Okay, so actually the change in energy, whenever change in energy happens, work is said to be done. So a body is capable of doing work. If a body is capable of doing work, we say it has some energy, because that energy is going to get converted for it to do work. Okay, now how do we measure energy? So it is measured in the same unit as that of work, because the energy possessed by a body is measured by the amount of work that body can perform. Okay, when a body does work, as I have already said, its energy decreases. Okay, and if work is done on a body, so energy is added to that particular body. In that case also, energy change is taking place. So there is not much to discuss about here. We move to units of energy, and you know, units of energy, the SI unit, if you are asked, the SI unit. So the SI unit is same as that of work, which is joule. Okay, and the CGS unit, if you are asked, so it is same as that of work, which is erg. And what is the relation? 1 joule is 10^7 erg. Okay, now we come to other units of energy. Okay, so another unit is watt hour. So this comes from the formula, actually, since power is work done by time. So work done is actually power into time, and you know, power is watt, and time can be written in hour. Okay, so watt hour. Okay, so watt hour is another unit of energy. Now how much is this energy, this unit, related to in terms of the SI system? So 1 watt hour, you can say 1 watt hour is equal to 1 watt into 1 hour. Okay, 1 hour, and 1 watt, you can see, is 1 joule per second. Okay, 1 watt is 1 joule per second. This we have studied already. And how much is 1 hour in terms of second? 1 hour is 60 minutes, and every minute is 60 seconds. So it is 60 into 60, which is 3600 seconds. So if you multiply, you'll get 3600 joule per second into second. So this will cancel out, and you'll get 3600 joule. Or you can say this as 3.6 kilojoule also. So this is the relation between 1 watt hour and the SI system, SI unit, joule. Okay, come to another unit, which is kilowatt hour. Okay, kilowatt hour. Now similarly, kilowatt hour is written as small k watt hour, like this, and 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1 kilowatt into 1 hour. Okay, and what is 1 kilowatt? 1 kilowatt is actually 1000 watt. Into 1 hour is actually 3600 seconds. And what is every watt? Every watt we have seen is 1 joule per second into 3600 second. So you get actually 3600, and then again 3 zeros, joule per second. So this comes out to be 3, 6, and then 5 zeros, joule, which can be written as 3.6 into 10^6 joule, or you can also write it as 3.6 in mega joule. Okay, mega joule, because I've already said 10^6 means mega. Okay, so this is the relation between kilowatt hour and SI system, SI unit, joule. Now remember, where is this particular unit used? So electrical energy, most probably you are familiar with this. If you see your electricity bill, electrical energy is measured in terms of kilowatt hour. Okay, so how do we define this 1 kilowatt hour? So we say 1 kilowatt hour, I'm writing this down, note this down. 1 kilowatt hour is the energy spent for work done by a source of power having 1 kilowatt, the power is 1 kilowatt in 1 hour. So if there is any object which is having a power of 1 kilowatt and he does work for 1 hour, whatever energy he that particular object spends is given by 1 kilowatt hour. Okay, now coming to another unit, the heat energy. Especially heat energy is usually measured, heat energy is referred, or its unit is referred to in terms of calorie. Okay, so what is the relation between joule and calorie? So remember, 1 calorie is equal to 4.186 joule. Okay, to be precise, we round it off and say 4.2 joule. Okay, 4.2 joule. Okay, so this is the relation. Okay, how do we define 1 calorie? So this is the definition, and you will learn more about this term when we do calorimetry chapter. I'm just writing the definition here, so you just note it down. Okay, 1 calorie is the energy that is required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water from 14.5 degrees Celsius to 15.5 degrees Celsius, or we can say to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water through 1 degree Celsius. Okay, through 1 degree Celsius also. So this is the definition of a calorie. We'll discuss this in more details in calorimetry chapter. Now coming to the fourth unit, the fourth unit is electron volt. Electron volt. Okay, so the energy of atomic particles, like that of an electron, proton, okay, neutron, we measure it in terms of electron volt, because these are very having very small amount of energies. Okay, so it is symbol is like this. And what is the relation between electron volt and the SI system? So 1 electron volt, remember, is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. So this is a question which has come many times in the board exams, like what is the relation between electron volt and joule. Okay, so remember this particular value. And if you need the definition, the definition goes like this, like 1 electron volt is the energy gained by an electron when it is accelerated through a potential difference of 1 volt. Now we'll discuss about this volt and other things in electricity chapter, but here I've just given you the definition if you are asked. So this is with regards to the different units of energy. So this is it for this video. We discussed about what power is and what energy is, and in the earlier video we discussed about what work is. So now you have a basic understanding of what work, power and energy are. Okay, now in the next video we are going to solve some numericals based on this particular concept of work, energy and power.